Hello, greetings from Cisco Systems. My name is Anand Raghava. I'm a manager in Cisco Systems. We are extremely happy to be part of the 13th International Conference on Software QA and Testing on Embedded Systems. Today, you will see a presentation from two of my team members, Praveena Sridhar and Vinay Jengiti, who are the quality champions and automation leads in Cisco Systems, and they will be talking on four-layered mobile automation framework architecture for multiple data sets. Over to you, Praveena and Vinay. Thank you for giving us this opportunity.
Good morning, everyone. It's Vinay from Cisco. So I'm going to start off the presentation. So our presentation is about four-layered mobile automation framework architecture for multi-data sets. Praveena, please, yeah. So here we are, myself and Praveena. I'm going to go through our overview. Yeah. Agenda is objective, Selendroid features, architecture, approach, future roadmap, references, and Q&A session. Objective. Problem statement. Mobile automation framework comes with common issues like static data, wherein the data is always static, doesn't have dynamic data. App dependencies. A few of the apps are native and few of the apps are hybrid, wherein we don't have a single framework to address this. Different voice versions, like having different versions for the same platform, like Unix have different flavors and Windows have different versions. Non-internationalization, like most of the frameworks doesn't address multiple languages, and general frameworks are black box testing, but here we are going to have white box testing as well. The UI is going to change regularly whenever there is a development going on phase by phase, and the user interface changes. So that is also addressed here. Solution framework using Selendroid and TestNG. The architecture is layered. Going through the Selendroid features, supports both native and hybrid apps on Android. So here there is no changes required for the app under test. Interacts simultaneously with multiple Android devices. Selendroid provides built-in inspectors to get the locators. Fully compatible with JSON WIRED protocol. And reuses existing Selenium infrastructure, like this is built over the existing WebDriver framework, though the APIs are being reused. Support for emulators or simulators and real devices. Yeah. So here we see the architecture. Praveena?
Yeah. So moving on to the Selendroid architecture, we have multiple layers over here. We have WebDriver client, we have the Selendroid standalone driver, the Selendroid standalone itself, and the app under test, which is coming under the mobile handset. Now, the WebDriver client is internally going to talk to the Selendroid standalone server, which has the driver to the Selendroid standalone, which will internally go and talk to the APK files or the apps under test in the hardware device. Getting into in-depth of this, what exactly happens is a JSON via protocol between the WebDriver client and the Selendroid standalone driver on the Selendroid standalone server, which internally talks to the Selendroid server to talk to app under test on the Android device or the emulator. Continuing with the tool architecture, it's based on the Android instrumentation framework and tests one map at a time. This contains three major components, Selendroid client, Selendroid server, and Selendroid standalone. The client is the one where we have the Java client library. It is primarily based on the Selenium Java client, what we use for web-based testing. We have a Selendroid server as such, which is running right next to the app under test on the Android device or on the emulator. And we have a Selendroid standalone server, which manages different devices by installing the Selendroid server and the app under test.
Hello.
Yes.
I'm going to speak about the inspector and locators. So here it's we have an inbuilt, Selendroid provides an inbuilt inspector. It works in a Chrome browser in debug mode. So it's equivalent to the Firefox Firebug or XPath checker or XPath viewer. So in this example, we are trying to get the XPath or the ID of the OK button. You can see views stub is being selected. So it's a type of view stub. And the ID is action underscore mode underscore bar underscore stub. So this is how we take the IDs or XPaths for the web, for the mobile.
Moving on to the architecture. We have the four layers, which is the test layer, basic layer, action layer, and the data layer. This is the stack which we have, where we have basic layer, action layer stack, action and test layer stack, TestNG stack, the data stack. We have the stack diagram of TestNG layer, which actually has a list of tests that we want to, the data that we want to provide to the test layer, and multiple combinations of data. And we actually have the test layer, which will have all the functional tests that we want to do on any Android application. This internally gets feed from a data layer, which has combinations of data that we want to pass to each of the functional tests. And this internally speaks to the action layer, which gives all possible actions which are possible, which can happen on a single page activity page or any of the Android apps. And this internally will make a call to the basic layer, which is the Selendroid driver asset. Getting into details of this is the slide where we can see that the TestNG suit file with the n-varied inputs will be fed as input to the controller, which is nothing but your test layer. And this makes a call to the action layer, which is the primary execution engine. And action layer internally, we have this controller speaking even to the Selendroid driver as part of the basic layer. And the execution engine will make request and response calls to a database to go check the data that we insert through the UI of the mobile is actually sitting into the right tables and database. And we have the request and response protocol over there. And the data that we want to pass to the test layer, we have a data manager where we have multiple combinations of input that we want to send, which will be taken care by the data layer. So this is the stack. Moving on to the basic layer, the in-depth understanding. First, we have Selendroid driver asset, which provides API for Android. Then we have driverfactory.java. This initializes mobile driver objects and it accepts parameters from TestNG layer. As you can see in the example below, we have a web driver that for which we are looking for a handle to the web driver. And we have the mobile APK file and the ID being passed as input for the Selendroid configuration, which internally is fed as input to Selendroid launcher, where you will get an object of Selendroid server. And Selendroid server object is used to get the final driver through which we want to execute the remaining test. This block diagram explains us the flow of data. And we have the TestNG suit XML, which provides multiple inputs to a particular test class. And this internally will send its data to the listeners, which will go and send multiple parameters to the driver. and which will make the call to the Selendroid driver. So within the basic layer, we have multiple kinds of Java files. One is constant, login page activity, resource bundle, and application constant. As far as constants.java is concerned, all the constants which we use across modules or across the framework is stored in the constants.java, which throughout the execution, which we know that they are not going to change. Coming to login page activity.java, since it's a common feature across multiple tests where we feed in the username and password, it's a common method which remains for multiple test cases which are possible on the Android app. We put it into a file called login page.activity.java, and this will get called as part of remaining test. Coming to resource bundle.java, as and when any particular mobile application is internationalized, meaning it is available in multiple languages, we don't have to test or rewrite the code for different language support. It will be written and tested in a for one language. But because of this resource bundle.java plugin that we have over here, we will have the equivalent of the text in one language into the other language. So when we have a global variable where we will set the language of this particular test automation, automatically the corresponding string for the original English equivalent will be taken and checked in the UI for the presence of it. So this will take care of multiple language support. Coming to application constant.java, this actually provides path to the configuration kind of properties where we have properties.java and also some SQL queries. Some of the examples being mobile APK file itself, the folder which contains this APK file, and also the folder which contains the SQL queries that we want to execute. All these configuration related details will be stored in application constant.java. Moving on to layer 2, which is action and test layer. So we have common UI action.java. This corresponds to all common actions which are possible in an activity page. Examples being clicking on some particular button or wait for element present in the UI after we click or do some action in the mobile app. And since these are common across multiple page activities, we club them in common UI action.java. And for application constant.java, we have already covered in the basic layer. Coming to page activity, this contains all actions performed in a particular page activity. So the example being the register user activity. So within the register user activity, page activity screen in the mobile app, whatever actions are possible, like registering a user activity itself, will be a particular method in this particular page activity.java file. Coming to the block diagram of the action or the test layer, we have the actual test class.java, which will speak to multiple page activity.java files in the sequence of the test functionality, wherein I have a login page. After I type in something in the login page, it takes me to the landing page or a home page, and I type in some particular feature, like maybe register an activity, it will take me to the register activity page. So all of these pages will be one particular Java file, and all the actions which we do on each of these will be our test class. And page activity itself will internally talk to common UI action.java, and it will identify the unique elements which are present on the page activity using the element locator. Moving on to test component.java, this is the place where we have the activity methods in a page being called in a sequential test call to complete one particular test functionality. And what it does is manual test case flow, it is converted into a page activity action for the activity. So here we can see an example of register user activity itself being a new page activity. And after we type in the inputs in registered user activity, we are going to go check the data that we have with the TestNG assert equals with the enter user details method. Whatever data we fed in, we go and check after the data is right or not with the verification successful method. moving on to the block diagram of the action on the test layer, the test class method, as summarized in the previous slide, it takes data from testdata.xml and the page activities. It takes data from the TestNG file. It goes and logs the data into the loggers. It has a it gets data from database and it also feeds into the database. We have support for the resource bundle, which is the internationalization stuff, where it can check for multi languages, and it talks to the listeners and also generates the reports. And we have all the data being transferred using Posure. Coming on to the helpers, we have DB data fetchers, and we also have data converters, where we convert data either from an XML or a CSV or a Excel file. Coming to the multi-database support, we give support for multiple databases like Oracle, Postgre, MySQL or SQL Server, and the connection parameters for each of these databases is parameterized. We can change it at runtime, and then we can create new connection to each of these databases and ensure that the data which is fed in the page activity screens actually go and fit into the corresponding database, and we do the verification. So the verification here is comparing data in DB and in the activity, and we use the TestNG assert for the CRUD on the component. The example here is, we get a driver for the profile activity page in the mobile phone, and we get a driver to that, which is we use this driver to get the user profile activity, and then we finally check that whatever data we put in the verify user details is same as the verification success. Moving on, yes.
I'm going to go through. Thanks, Praveena. I'm going to go through on layer 3 and 4. layer 3 is data layer. So we use XMLs for passing data as test data. Data XMLs are sent as input to the test layer. The details provided in the data XMLs are the parameterized values of the attributes. For the user component, the different attributes of the users are being converted to the component beam. Here in the example, we can see the username, email, phone, password, confirm password are all been having a corresponding details in the component beam. Next page, yeah, Praveena. So TestNG data provider provides data for the data XMLs per method basis. So as I described in my previous slide, so here we can see the parsing is being done of each data XMLs and is being converted into the bean object. So we are using DOM parser for parsing the XMLs. Yeah, next. So layer 4 is TestNG layer. Here, next layer, next slide, please. In the TestNG layer, we can see the TestNG suit.xml. It's an input for the driver factory.java. So we are using the different listeners, and we pass the parameters from here, and the user details and the login details have been passed here, and the particular class which is going to be tested. So the control starts from here. So takes the corresponding details which are provided here, and the control is passed down to the respective class specified here. And once this control is passed to the respective the test layer, the tests are going to be executed. Then the control is back to TestNG layer, where corresponding report is generated and email has been passed or sent to respective owners. Next slide, please. So in test floor, in the layer 4, we are using listeners, controls the execution of the flow, and report generation is done here. Reporting, we have general reports, and we send emails. Formats are HTML and PDF formats. So once the execution is done, corresponding report is generated, and report is sent as email to the respective owners, and report types are chart generator, mail generator, and custom report generator. In custom report generator, we have specific details which are specific to our product. We provide the config details, the app server, the database, the build number, the date, and the corresponding pass and fail details. Next slide, please. Utilities, we are using different utilities across the layers. Common utilities, you can we are providing an example of Excel sheet reading. So here we read the Excel and we use those parameters in the project. And the test management tool to update the results. We have an internal tool, Cisco internal tool called TIMS. So once the reports are generated, we have code to update the results corresponding in the tool. And property utility to read all the locators. As Praveena already said, we take the locators from the UI and place it in property files. The IDs are being used to click or any actions in the UI. Zip utility, which zips the files, it's an internal requirement. So these are the examples we have provided here. Next slide, please. So over to you, Praveena.
Yeah. So thanks, Vinay. I'll be looking at the conclusion part of it, wherein we look at advantages and the future roadmap for this particular framework. Let us look at the advantages of the framework. First coming is scalability. A single test case can be executed with multiple users with different privileges. It gives a lot of test coverage, wherein we don't have to rewrite these test cases. It's a matter of parameterizing the test case with different privileged users. And we have the ease of maintenance, which is also an advantage, wherein any change which happens to the page activity, we just need to modify the framework in only one of the place because of the four-layered architecture. As far as data availability is concerned, because we are using POJOs, it will enable us with easy transfer of data. And page activity itself, the way the structure of the page activity and the layered structure, it gives an abstraction of logic to the testers who do not need to have a knowledge of the full tool. They can just code in the test layer, wherein an expert programmer can probably be working on the action layer and the basic layer, and people can still get the functional coverage in the test layer by just calling the test layer who have where we provide the abstraction of logic. And since the framework is object oriented, it can be extended to add more features. And it does give parallel execution support, but for a single app at a time, when we'll have multiple Selendroid drivers making calls to the app under test. We have multi-data support where we can have combinations of data which can be fed as input. That will give us a lot of test coverage. Coming on to the future roadmap, so the whole framework development with the current features which are listed in this particular presentation took around 4 months for this mobile development, for this framework development. And this can be extended to build acceptance tests, functional verification tests, end-to-end tests, and also internationalization tests for large-scale projects. We have plans of using this for upcoming Cisco products in the mobile space, where we are going to leverage this framework to get maximum test coverage and also get in-depth testing. There are efforts required for framework modification to accommodate this particular thing. The changes in activity is minimal, so it actually helps us in our roadmap to add more to our tests because the change is minimal. And this can be extended to other platforms other than Android, example, iOS. This is the reference where which gives the list of jar files that we have used for this particular framework development. Selendroid driver, TestNG, JDK version, JDBC jar, PDF API, CSV, and the XLS API. Any Q&A? Welcome. Thank you, everybody, for giving us this opportunity to speak at this conference.
Thank you.